Hey guys, hope everything's going well. You guys know that drill. Smash that like button, subscribe if you haven't, comment down below. Follow me on Instagram at AIH_sports. Follow me on my finance channel at AIH Finance. Okay, a few things. So eBay's authenticity program. Before I critique it, I do want to say some positive aspects about this. And also, make sure to comment about how this authentication program is for you. So I'm in the process of getting this one card that I bought. It was authenticated by PSA. It's a graded card. I'll show you probably in the next few days. And in that aspect, it's relieving to find out that PSA took a look at that card and there's an authentication process behind it. So that's a net positive, okay? And once again, once I get in the next few days, I'll probably show it to you. Now, there is a negative aspect to this. And I was looking at Merle Worlds, my man Merle, that's right. His Instagram showed that he bought a bunch of Snoop Dogg cards that it said that it would be authenticated, but it wasn't. It was not listed properly or was categorized incorrectly. So when you look at that, you have to see that the seller messed up, but the buyer ends up getting it when the buyer thought that these cards would be authenticated. Now, Morley said that, hey, I'm just going to send it to PSA to get it graded or something like that. Now, I'm just thinking, now, what can scammers do to exploit this situation? Because I think they will, and they have. So, I'm over at eBay Authentication Terms of Service for their authentication guarantee listing, so the term and conditions, and this is what they say, and this is how I think people or scammers are going to exploit this, which they probably have. The following items are not eligible for authenticity guarantee: items whose listing do not bear the authenticity guarantee blue checkmark badge, items listed in categories not named above, sets, lots, kits, decks, boxes, and packs of two or more cards. Okay, just note that. So anyone trying to buy cards, they want authenticated. Well, sets won't be authenticated. Lots won't be authenticated. Here's what Merle had to deal with. Miscategorized items, other types of cards listed in eligible categories, cards that contain additional items, embellishments, or memorabilia, such as patches, jerseys, swatch equipment, props, relics, costumes, or wardrobe cards. Autograph cards, art cards, redemption cards, additional cards that are gifted to buyers as a bonus and free of charge, items purchased using an offline payment method, listings that offer local pickup. Think about that. How many people do listings that offer pickup? 1980 Star Company basketball cards. Items shipped to P.O. boxes, items shipped to and from unincorporated territories, okay, ineligible items will not be authenticated. So, let's get this straight. You're buying cards and it doesn't fit under these categories. So then the buyer is left, you could say, left holding the bag. And you can't return the item, it looks like. Unless maybe you could throw a fit and say, hey, the seller was misleading or whatever, etc. But this is not, how should I say it? This does not help the process. Because you're buying with the assumption that it's going to be authenticated, but then it doesn't become authenticated. Now, some people will be like, hey, you didn't look at the terms of services. Okay. But a lot of people are going to be salty. In my opinion, eBay needs to change these terms of services. The thing is that what people may do, they may put fakes, they may put trim cards, etc., and they may purposely mislabel it, miscategorize it. Or they could just say, offer local pickup. And then the buyer gets the card, and guess what? They can't return it. No return policy. And then the buyer is left holding the bag. See, this is how I think sellers are going to exploit the system, and this is not a good system that eBay has in place. I'm surprised that they have these terms of services. But yeah, suppose there's multiple cards, right? And then you see authenticity guarantee, and then they're buying, like I said the other day, there's appears to be some 2000 chrome cards that may be trimmed, may be reprints, and are not high grades, in my opinion. And those are floating around. Someone buys Ace. Look, it's authenticity guarantee. They're left holding the bag, assuming that it's trimmed or it's fake. eBay needs to definitely do something about this, because when they say, oh, it's authentic, it's guaranteed, a lot of people are like, oh, I'm going to buy it, right? Then you can't return it. This is the problem. A lot of people don't know about this, and some people are going to learn it the hard way, throw a lot of money at cards that aren't worth that much. And eBay, you know, I don't think they're doing a good job regarding this. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about this. Remember to smash that like button, subscribe if you haven't, comment down below, guys. Thank you. Bye.